you can. Cat Cut Towers Hotel, what was your mic? Ken and Mike are going to perform for your entertainment, ladies and gentlemen, Banjo Patterson's classic poem, The Man from The Man from Snowy River. Get the horses! The Man from Ironbark! Brilliant, we've got it. So, you'll be the man from Ironbark, my darling. You're a bushy. Look at you. You look good. And you'll be the barber in the barber shop. Have you got it?
Got it.
Got it. You got it? You're with the plot so far? Any questions? It was the man from Ironbark who strode the Sydney town. He wandered over Street Park.
Man from Ironbark.
He wandered. He wandered up. And down. He loitered here. He loitered there. Till he was like to drop, like, oh, I'm going over act, mate. There we go. Until at last, in sheer despair, sit down, my darling man, he sought a barber's shop. Give me a pointed finger here. Point your finger. That's it. Here.
Yeah. Here.
Shave me beard and whiskers off.
Shave me beard and whiskers off.
Good man. I'll be a man of mark.
I'll be a man of mark.
I'll go and do the Sydney toff.
I'll go and do the Sydney toff.
Excellent. Back home in Ironbark.
Back home in Ironbark.
Excellent. The barber man was small. The barber man was small. Oh, don't suck it in, Mike. Oh, he's got a little hernia. Don't suck it in, mate. You'll do yourself a mischief. It's true. We had a bloke up here. He sucked his guts in so bad one night that his belly button fell out his bum. The barber man was small. As barbers mostly are. He wore a strike your fancy sash. He smoked a huge cigar. Ooh. You can tell it's legal in Canberra. He got six plants in the backyard. They're all smoking away. He was a humorist of note and keen at repartee. He laid the odds and kept a tote. Whatever that might be. And when he saw our friend arrive, he whispered, here's a lark.
Here's a lark.
Just watch me.
Just watch me.
Take him all alive.
Take him all alive.
This man from Ironbark.
This man from Ironbark.
Excellent. There were some gilded youths. Where the hell will we get youths? Along the barber's wall. Their eyes were dull. Their heads were flat. Can you stand up for me, my darling? Face everyone. They had no brains at all. To them, the barber passed the wink. Would you wink to him? He winked back. His dexter eyelid shut. I'll make this bloomin' yokel.
I'll make this bloomin' yokel.
Think his bloomin' throat's been cut.
Think his bloomin' throat's been cut.
Excellent. And as he soaked and rubbed it in. Give me a shave. He made a rude remark. I suppose the flats is pretty green.
I suppose the flats are pretty grim.
Up there in Ironbark.
Up there in Ironbark.
Good man. A grunt was all reply he got. Mate, you're from Ironbark. It's a bushy. I want a little. Oh, look, there's a little. There it is. I need a good grunt from you, mate. A grunt was all reply he got. He got. He shaved the bushman's chin. Then made the water boiling hot and dipped his razor in. He raised his arm. His brow grew black. He paused a while to gloat. Then slashed the red hot razor back across the victim's throat. Upon the newly shaven skin, it left a livid mark. No doubt it fairly took him in. The man
from Ironbark.
He fetched a wild upcountry yell. That was pretty bloody good. Not wait for the dead to hear. And though he knew his throat full well was cut from ear to ear, he struggled gamely to his feet. Get up, mate, get up. Hey! Two-face, can you two-face each other? Two-face, exactly. Brilliant. His murderous foe. You've done for me.
You've done for me.
You dog.
I'm beat.
One hit before I go. Point your finger again. I only wish I had a knife. You blessed murdering shark. But you'll remember all your life. The man from Ironbark. He lifted up his hairy paw. With one tremendous clout, it landed on the barber's jaw.
Wow.
And knocked the barber out. That's right, he needs a round of applause for that. It's the best thing that's happening to all day. Look at that. He set to work with tooth and nail and made the place a wreck. Wreck the joint, mate. Wreck it. He grabbed the nearest gilded youth and tried to break his neck. Throaty held to save his vital spark and murder.
Murder.
Bloody murder.
Bloody murder.
Cried
the man from Ironbark.
Up here, a man who heard the din came in to see the show and tried to run the bushman in. But he refused to go. Refused to go, though.
No.
And when at last the barber woke up again, there he is. He's from Canberra, remember? He likes it now. How shiny is your bum? And said,
It was all in fun.
A harmless little joke.
A harmless little joke.
A trifle overdone.
A trifle overdone.
I thought that was well done. A joke.
A joke?
He cried. No, that's my line. By George, that's fine. A lively sort of laugh.
I'd like to catch that murdering swine.
One night.
In Ironbark.
Excellent. Now, I've done a lot of things in poetry over the years. I really have. Just one night, it would be great to get John Omawadi up here for this. And now, around the shearing floor, you listening, Shearer's Gate. He tells his story, rags of his escape. Them barber chaps. What keeps a tote? By George, I've had enough. You should try doing a poem up here with these two. I've had enough. One tried to cut me blooming throat. But thank the Lord it's tough. And whether he's believed or no, there's one thing to remark. Flowing beards are all the go up there in
Ironbark.
Well done, boys.